All right, welcome back to American Truck Simulator. I am the Spear. I've just taken found a good job to take a pressure tank. We've taken the pressure tank before, from Nogales to Camp Verde. Camp Verde is a new city we haven't been to before. Plenty of time to make the load. It's going to pay us $4,300, and as you can see in this picture, we'll be driving a DAF, which isn't actually part of American Truck Simulator. It is a mod. I believe I have mods for most of the trucks to bring them over from ETS into American trucks. So that's good. Let's check out this. What do we got here? We've got an interesting little truck. Well, that's going to be a little hard to read. One thing I noticed right away, we're in kilometers per hour as our. I think all the Euro trucks that have been ported over, they didn't change anything. So we won't be able to see miles per hour. DAF. What do we got here? Turbo pressure. Fuel usage, air pressure, fuel info, speed info. Let's go with speed info. Since we don't have miles per hour on the... in there, we might not want to use kilometers per hour. All right, so it's a little bit hard getting used to everything in this DAF. Anytime you're driving a new truck, you know, it can be hard to get used to all the different dials and knobs and everything, so take your time. This DAF, fairly utilitarian, kind of nice, though. No complaints so far. We're leaving Suntex. I think we can beat that little. That guy's going awfully slow, giving us plenty of opportunity to get in here. All right, so we're starting way down at the bottom, Nogales. And we're going about halfway up Arizona to Camp Verde. We're going to get some. Nah, I'm alright. I was thinking about getting some Chinese takeout, but I think we're alright. I do wish the GPS was a little bit higher. It's kind of low. I gotta keep looking down to see the GPS, but we won't need it much more. We're gonna get on the highway, and hopefully from there it'll be a nice smooth run. This is Nogales. Ooh, they're building something there, something quite big. I wonder what that could be. Wonder if we'll ever find out what it's going to be. Nogales is a nice little city. It's just so far out of the way that it's not really someplace we're going to visit very often. Because it's right at the bottom. On the highway, and then we can talk a bit. DAF. Airbag. Looks like it's got a nice retarder. Everything should be fine. Alright, leaving Nogales. Speed limit 65 down here. The other parts of Arizona gets up to 80, but. I guess we're still near cities. Whenever you're near a city, it seems to go down to 65. On to Cape Verde. Through Tucson. Alright. Like I said, we've had this pressure vessel before, but nothing wrong with making a run to a new city. I've been thinking about what kind of games to play here on the screen. You know, what things I like, what things people might like to see. So I've decided I'm going to probably put in a couple more games in the mix. Probably, I'm thinking four is probably a good number. Four games, I think that's a good number. We can cycle through them. You know, it doesn't have to be a different game every day. You know, maybe I can play a game a couple days in a row, two or three days in a row. But whatever, we want to find something, you know, that's interesting and fun to play, of course. So most of the games I'm thinking about are driving games. Not always the newest games. I'm not much for first-person shooters, things like that. I like to drive. As you can probably tell, I'm playing American Truck. I like to drive. I'm not the world's best driver, or fastest driver, or most careful driver. But I have a good time playing driving. So they'll probably mostly be driving. Well, the one game I do have right now, I haven't done anything with, is Project Cars. And that's about the typical thing. It's been out for a while. Came out in 2015, maybe, probably a couple of years, 3 years maybe. But, you know, being the newest game doesn't mean it's a good game, so just try games and see if I like them or not. I don't really know too much about Project Cars. I know it's a good game. I mean, it's been around for a while. I like it. There's lots of different cars to, What happened there? Oh my goodness! This is why we need an instant replay. Oh boy, I am stuck here. Okay, like I said, driving may not be from home. Driving may not be the best thing for me. Racing and talking might even be worse. Oh my god. Now that I'm really thinking about it, how am I going to race and drive? Where are they towing me off to? Alright, they've towed me to a service entrance. This looks like Tucson, actually. Yep, I'm in Tucson. You know you've played a lot when you know where you are just from, just from a picture. All right, where's Camp Verde? All right, up through Phoenix to Camp Verde. Okay, so we actually made some time. Well, sort of. Not in a good way. Let's repair the truck, get back on, get out of here. That's quite the way to begin the trip, isn't it? With a nice accident. I'm right on the repair spot, aren't I? Oh wow, 27% cabin, 34%. That was a, well, now I know why I don't have any money. Wow. I've really got to be more careful. Really need to be more careful. I'm pretty sure I'd be fired by now. Lost my CDL. Well, that's pretty disappointing, but so if I'm gonna drive something like Project Cars, you can bet I'm probably gonna get into an accident or two. And flip. Whoa. Do well enough on my own, I don't need people running into me. But that's the kind of thing. And then the other fun games, anything I think would be fun to play. Typically not the newest games. I think it'll just be something that gets good reviews, that lots of people like, fun game. You know, something like that would be best. Whatever it might be. Nothing shooting, can't shoot too well. whatever catches my fancy. Or if you've got a suggestion, you know, feel free to drop a suggestion, either as a comment or email or what have you. See what I can do. I like that No Man's Sky. I think that's a interesting game. It's not too complicated. I don't want to play games that are too complicated or, you know, take too much effort to think about. Just a good, relaxed, chill, fun game. Like driving a truck. If I would ever just stop hitting things, I might have a chance to relax. I think what happened last time is I was over on the outside lane passing that truck. I think I hit something on the outside and it pushed me all the way over to the inside. And I went over that fence. That would have been a perfect time for an instant replay. I so wish there was instant replay in this game. You know, it doesn't have to be long, you know, 10, 15 seconds. Just so you can see what happened. Funny stuff like that. In a different view. I mean, from the cab, I really couldn't see anything. I mean, I saw I was hitting something. And then I saw I moved over to the other side and hit something over there. But I think a third camera external replay would have been great. As for this truck, I wish they had switched the location of the radio and GPS. That way I could see the GPS here. Instead of always looking down. Which I'm sure will lead to a problem sooner or later when I get lost because I couldn't see the GPS. But I think we're going just up 10. Does 10 go all the way to Camp Verde? I should have looked on the map. Now we're going through Phoenix to Camp Verde, so it's not that long a trip. It's just I'd like to know where I'm exactly supposed to be turning. Phoenix, of all the cities, I think Phoenix can be the most confusing. Just because there's so many different turns and ramps, exits, entrances, highways. It's a little weird. Am I speeding? I get the feeling I'm speeding. This guy's telling me I'm speeding. This guy's telling me I'm speeding. Everyone's slowing down substantially. I don't know why. Speed limit 75. It always freaks me out when you see a bunch of cars that are just slowing and stopping. It's like, am I doing something wrong? Am I about to rear end them? But paying attention solved that problem. Am I still in Tucson? I don't know what all those exits were. But Phoenix is just pretty confusing. Even if you're just trying to go straight through, I don't think you can go straight through. I think you always have to make some turn. If not, you don't have to get off the highway, but the highway will curve and have turns. Like I was going 100 miles an hour. From what I understand about cars is there's different style of racing on different circuits, different cars. What I like mostly, I like open wheel stuff, Formula One, that kind of thing. Oh, well, that reminds me, I should drive Formula One. Formula One 2016, I think, is the latest that's out. Should I drive 2016? I looked at reviews, and they actually say, like, the reviews say that 2013 was actually the best year for Formula One. But I imagine the rules and everything have changed since then, so maybe I should go with 2016. But again, I need the latest new game. If 2013 is a great game, I'll play 2013. That's the idea, just to be entertaining, have fun. Good racing. So we'll see what this Project Cars is about. I'll do some open wheel racing. I don't think I've ever really been a fan of other kind of racing. We're going straight. Like NASCAR, things like that. I'm not really into NASCAR. So I think some of the Project Car stuff actually is like sedans and stuff, and I don't think I would be that interested in that. But who knows? You know, maybe I play one and I say, this is really awesome, I want to play all of them. So we shall see. But hopefully that'll make it enjoyable watching. You know, something that you'd want to watch. Not sure how much I could talk during a race. Races won't be that long, you know, you can't keep these episodes going on forever. It's just enough to have fun. It's dark out there. Alright. So we did waste a little bit of time. Oh, we've got plenty of time. We've got till Wednesday afternoon. It's only Tuesday night. Camp Verde is not too far off. How much further? 64 miles. So yeah, see, we'll make it there no problem. I guess if we need, even if we needed to take a rest and sleep, there's just so much time that you need to make these deliveries. Since it's not mine, but it was so damaged that it was probably going to die several times. I've had that when I'm streaming on Twitch, I've gotten in an accident, and you know, before you can find some place to repair it, the engine keeps dying and you're stranded somewhere because you had some kind of accident. So it's just better to get that taken care of so you can drive without worrying about stopping and pulling over every so often. It must be coming up on Camp Verde. I'm a little hesitant to get too close to all these cars in front of them. I mean, if you look at them, you can always see them, that they're bright, their brake lights keep coming on, so they're slowing down every once in a while, like that one. I don't want to get caught out suddenly. See, look at that. I'm going 44 and I'm still catching up with the guy. I guess that truck ahead of him isn't really going too fast. Look, Camp Verde. Another city on our list. Another car game. I don't have this one. I have Project Cars. The other one was BNG. That one looked pretty good too. That gets good reviews on Steam. And again, it's a couple years old, but people still say it's one of the better driving games out there. And that's what we're looking for, best games. I'm about to run out of fuel, but it's not my truck, so I can deliver it on fumes. I've already paid enough to get it repaired. I don't need to pay to fill up the tank. Here. Oh, great. I'll follow that cop into town. Maybe he's giving me an escort to make sure that I don't get into the kind of accident I got in down by Tucson. Nope, he's going that way. Sunny Camp Verde. Plus, what game I play will depend on if it takes track IR. I love this track IR. Just being able to look around, it's awesome. I can't imagine why games would not incorporate it. It does not cost money to incorporate track IR. You just have to put in the coding for it, which I guess costs money. You gotta pay people to do it, but it's so amazing. I don't know how I played for so long without it. Hopefully we get something out of this. I know it's really damaged, but hopefully not too damaged. I guess if you damage a pressure tanker, maybe it won't hold pressure if it gets too much damage. So I guess they have a good point there if they do dock me. Some farm. What's this farm doing with the pressure tank? And we're in Camp Verde. The Camp Verde farm. Let's see what they want us to do. Well, I need to get some of this XP back because I'm going to lose XP from that accident. Well, I need to get all the XP I can out of this. All right, there it is. Need to go between a couple things. I am moving, right? Well, I was moving. This is just one thing after another. It's been a heck of a trip. Let's see if this guy will help us. Hey, dude. Hey, can you help me back into that spot over there? You know, just tell me when to turn. Dude, hey. What's wrong with that guy? All right, he's not gonna help. That's not cool. Not cool, dude. That's a nice looking truck. No complaints there. But all right, let's see where we're going. We're going back and back and back. And I'm not at a good angle, really. But let's just go. Let's get over there. Oops. Thanks, dude. I mean, I would have come helped you with your for a harvester. I guess I should have paid more attention in Farming Sim, sorry. This looks like a good angle. We're pretty far away, so I got plenty of time before. It's really hard to see out of that. Thank you. goofing off too much with that guy. Fixing his harvester. Or whatever you call it, the front of the harvester. Combine. Oh, yeah, we're not gonna make that. But we'll come in at a better angle. The other mirror is pretty much useless. I don't know where they can get. It's impossible for me to see through the other mirror. I don't know how they think I would see through it. I mean, look at that. Well, actually, it's. It could be worse. But it's just a lot easier seeing this side. Even when you can't see, I mean, you've got an idea. You can see the front of it. I'm just not having good luck tonight. What's going on? Let's get out and look at it. This is not my night. I tell you that. The accident. Speeding tickets. Slow and sure wins the race. And there you go. A little hard to see behind the hay. There you go. Pressure tanker delivered. And I'm hoping the damage isn't too bad. It's going to be easy to pull out of here. Well, no, not anymore. Not even my truck. I can't even pull off. Tolerable. Yeah, that accident really whammied the... look at that. 14.7%. Oh, that killed me. Lost most of my money. Still made a little bit of money. Oh, 437 XP I lost. The base reward was only 424, so I really needed to park. Parking was half my XP for that job. Wow. Yeah, so let that be a lesson. Accidents, they're going to hurt you. The damage penalty is a killer. Boy, and 1700, I think I spent that on repairs. Oh. Oh, and the speeding ticket. Well, I used to have 15,000. So, all right, so we made a few hundred dollars on this delivery. That was not so exciting, making a few hundred dollars, but it's better than nothing. Well, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed watching me crash and need to watch me crash some more, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to these videos, all these videos. We've got American Truck Simulator, No Man's Sky, and soon we'll have some Project Cars uploaded. See how I do in that. I get a feeling there's going to be a few accidents. Well, this is a Spear. Thanks for watching.